What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, seems as if undefeated WBC lightweight world champion superstar boxer Devin the Dream Haney will have a dance partner, a valid dance partner, in November, coming in the form of former IBF featherweight world champion, superstar Mexican boxer Joseph Jojo Diaz. 32 wins, 1 loss, 1 draw, 15 wins by way of knockout. He's 28 years of age. He stands at 5'6" with a 64-inch arm reach. Joseph Jojo Diaz, last Friday, he beat WBC mandatory lightweight challenger in Javier Fortuna. He got a unanimous decision victory. And it was a shocker because Joseph Jojo Diaz just made his first appearance at 135 pounds. He was at 130. He lost his belt at super featherweight, junior lightweight, on the scales, okay? He stated that he struggled to make weight, so he had to move up. He moved up to 135. With that said, Devin Haney, 26 wins, no losses, no draws, 15 wins by way of knockout. He's 22 years of age, stands at 5'8" with a 71-inch arm reach. Last time we saw him in the ring was May of 2021 when he took on three-division world champion superstar boxer Jorge Linares and got a unanimous decision victory. With that said, Devin Haney is 6 years younger than Joseph Jojo Diaz. Devin Haney is the undefeated WBC lightweight world champion, and Joseph Jojo Diaz, this is mandatory. Why is this important? Because yesterday we got news that undefeated five-time world champion, three-division world champion superstar boxer Gervonta Tank Davis was interested in fighting Joseph Jojo Diaz. Now, Joseph Jojo Diaz, after his fight with Javier Fortuna, he stated that he wanted to either fight Devin Haney or upcoming rising Mexican superstar title contender King Rod Ryan Garcia in his next fight. Okay? He fought his last fight on DAZN with Oscar De La Hoya and Golden Boy Promotions against Javier Fortuna, okay? With Samson as a promoter as well. So, with that said, we got reports yesterday that Joseph Diaz could be heading into a showdown with Devin Haney in October. With Gervonta Tank Davis in October after he publicly agreed to fight Devin Haney in November. Devin Haney, he stated to Joseph Jojo Diaz, you know, you my mandatory. Why is it hard to make this fight happen? You know, Joseph Diaz said, you know, you can stop talking, stop running your mouth, so on and so forth. You know, because we will be fighting in November. We can secure the fight in November. That was after he fought Javier Fortuna. And then yesterday we got news that Gervonta Tank Davis, his team, were interested in making a fight happen between Gervonta Tank Davis and Joseph Jojo Diaz in October. And it seems like there was mutual interest, and that would be the route that Joseph Diaz is going to go. Since then, Joseph Jojo Diaz, he responded to Devin Haney, says, "You and my mandatory again, you making it hard. It sounds like you the one backpedaling out this fight." Joseph Diaz says that now I'm going to do everything in my power. I'm going to call my team this weekend and look to secure and make this fight happen with Devin Haney and turn down the opportunity should it present itself officially to fight Gervonta Tank Davis. So now Joseph Diaz is saying that he's going to go after Devin Haney. He's not going to pursue Gervonta Tank Davis if the fight is offered to him. That's great news. Why is it great news? Because we want to see the best fighting the best in the weight class that they're in, not catch weights, not bouncing all around. You know, if you become the mandatory challenger for the champion, fight the champion. We saw Ryan Garcia become the mandatory challenger for Devin Haney after he beat Olympic gold medalist, British superstar title contender Luke Campbell. And then he stated he himself wanted to pursue Gervonta Tank Davis. Devin Haney was ringside. He got in the ring with him before. He became the mandatory. And he tells Devin Haney after the fight, "If I can't secure a fight with Gervonta Tank Davis, then I'll secure a fight between myself and you." Well, he didn't secure the fight with Gervonta Tank Davis because he decided to walk away from the Gervonta Tank Davis fight. And he stated that he had an opportunity to fight legendary 8-division world champion, iconic Filipino superstar boxer Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao in his next fight. Well, that proved not to be true, and Ryan Garcia then secured a fight between himself and Javier Fortuna for this June 9th date, And he pulled out of that fight as well, cited health issues. Thus, the reason why Joseph Jojo Diaz, he filled in for Ryan Garcia. So you see how the dominoes have fallen, okay? And so now Joseph Diaz, Javier Fortuna was the mandatory, so was Ryan Garcia. And now Joseph Diaz beats Javier Fortuna. He becomes the mandatory challenger for Devin Haney. And it seemed like he could be going in a different direction, okay? It seemed like Gervonta Tank Davis and his team was going to swoop in and look to secure a fight with Joseph Diaz instead of showing interest in fighting Devin Haney, okay? They didn't show interest in fighting Devin Haney, but they were showing interest in fighting Joseph Jojo Diaz, okay? So with that said, now it seems like we're going to get this fight. Devin Haney told Joseph Diaz, let's see if you actually stand on your square and make this fight happen. Joseph Diaz says there's no backpedaling on his part. He's going to contact his team this weekend, and they're going to make it happen. This is a great fight for Devin Haney. This is a great fight for Joseph Jojo Diaz, okay? Joseph Diaz, he beat Tevin Farmer. He was the underdog, but he beat Tevin Farmer for the IBF belt. He lost the fight to Mr. Gary Russell Jr., the longest reigning champion in the sport of boxing, WBC featherweight world champion. And he just beat Javier Fortuna. So Joseph Diaz, he has some good victories under his belt, some nice big fights under his belt. He only has the loss to Mr. Gary Russell Jr., you know, and this is another big fight for Joseph Diaz, as well as this is another big fight for Devin Haney. Now, Devin Haney, every day, Devin Haney is fighting better and better opposition. Everybody called for Devin Haney to start stepping up in level of competition. Well, he fought Olympic gold medalist, three-division world champion, Yuriorkis Gamboa. He outclassed Gamboa, winning every single round. Then he fought three-division world champion, superstar boxer Jorge Linares, and he outclassed Jorge Linares. He had the one hiccup in the 10th round, the end of the 10th round, 5 seconds or less in the end of the 10th round when he got clipped by a punch that he didn't see, got hurt, got buzzed, and he just secured the victory in the 11th and 12th round, not making the mistakes and putting himself in the risk of losing the fight. But for the most part, including the 10th round, he won every single round, okay? And so now to go into a fight with Joseph Jojo Diaz, these are three straight world champions, okay? Legit, credible world champions. This is what you asked for from Devin Haney at 22 years of age. At 22 years of age, look at the level of opposition that he's fighting, okay? So this is a huge fight for both guys. I personally am going to favor Devin Haney. His style, I believe, is all wrong for Joseph Jojo Diaz. I believe that the movement of Devin Haney, the jab, the reach, the athletic ability, the quick feet is going to be too much for Joseph Diaz. Joseph Diaz, you know, a much shorter guy at 5'6", you know, with a 64-inch arm reach. So Devin Haney's going to have an 8-inch arm reach advantage also over Joseph Diaz. He's going to have a 2-inch height advantage over Joseph Diaz. And ultimately, he has the athletic ability over Joseph Jojo Diaz. And so, with that said, we saw boxers give Joseph Diaz problems like Gary Russell Jr. But then he solved the problem with a slick defensive boxer in Tevin Farmer. Okay, now Tevin Farmer, he stated that, you know, there was a lot of things that took place with Tevin Farmer, you know, but he don't make any excuses. But, you know, Tevin Farmer, you know, surprisingly fought the entire fight with Joseph Diaz in the pocket. Tevin Farmer was seen as one of the most slick defensive boxers in boxing. So to see him standing flat-footed right in front of Joseph Diaz the entire night, and he kept looking up at the clock, okay, was very strange, you know, was very surprising. And Joseph Diaz, he took, he took full advantage of it, and he capitalized on it. And he won the fight, won the IBF title. It was a big fight. So with that said, Joseph Diaz, he showed slight stamina issues in a fight with Javier Fortuna. But that was impressive victory, in my opinion, over Javier Fortuna, because Javier Fortuna is a rough, rugged. He straddles the line of, you know, some people say is, you know, he uses some illegal tactics, you know, but he's a rough, rugged southpaw, you know, that punches hard. You know, he's experienced, you know, unorthodox. Throws punches as strange angles. And Joseph Diaz, he won unanimous decision. I thought he clearly won the fight. as well as the judges. You know, I picked Joseph Diaz to win the fight as well. You know, so that was an impressive victory over Javier Fortuna. So Joseph Diaz garnered experience. He's a very credible opponent, and this is going to be a great fight. So it looks like they're planning this fight to take place in November. Now we have to see who Gervonta Tank Davis replaces his opponent with. But this is great news because it becomes frustrating what takes place in the sport of boxing. You know, if Gervonta Tank Davis is a Joseph Diaz is a option, then Devin Haney should be an option. Okay, and Devin Haney doesn't seem like he's ever an option for Gervonta Tank Davis. So we want to see the best fight, the best, point blank and period. Gervonta Tank Davis is a superstar in the sport of boxing. He's a pay-per-view star, and we want to see him fight the absolute best as well. But I love this fight, and I love the fact that Joseph Jojo Diaz is going to stand on his square and say, listen, I said I was going to fight Devin Haney, not going to fight Gervonta Tank Davis, doing everything in my power to make this fight happen with Devin Haney in November. And he told Devin Haney, don't backpedal out this fight. Devin Haney said, the only one trying to backpedal is you, and you the mandatory. This should be easy to make. So let's see how this unfolds and plays out. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
You're watching Blue Bud Sports TV. Wow.